Keith Thurman fought Soto Grass. It was a great fight for the whole nine rounds. Wasn't a second that was boring.
I'm only liking Thurman more and more and more. And I look at the guy, and he's as explosive as all hell. You know, out of nowhere, late in the fight, will just come up with a combination that will just leave you senseless. That's cool to see. He has a lot of confidence to him as well. And now I look at Thurman, and yeah, look, I see a lot of chinks in the armor. That's true. But I also see a guy that is consistently improving fight by fight. And that's a great thing to see. You know, he's that much better than the fight before. And I believe he'll be that much better than this previous fight. Soto Carras coming off a huge head of momentum. Really in the fight to win it. Couldn't deal with Thurman's explosive power. I mean, the guy's a real puncher. He believes it. He's going to go after that punch. He seems to have multi-dimensions to his game. He is a little loosey-goosey and open. Like, I can see him getting countered. In fact, I can see him getting starched by a shot, too. Like, you know, if you're throwing that uppercut from too far away, like he was against Soto Carras. But whatever he's going to be doing, it's going to be exciting. And who would I like him to see? Anybody at welterweight. You know, he'll probably get somebody from, you know, the ranking of 10 to 5 in the welterweight division, and I would love to see him against them. And I think he's got a chance against anybody, you know, below the top 5 of the welterweight division right now. And maybe only improve.
Okay, Adil has a question for you, Coach. What is the best way to improve breathing and stamina for a person who is also asthmatic and gets out of breath quickly?
Oh, so the little information I have on working with asthmatic athletes is that you want to do a long, low-level, drawn-out warm-up to help open the lungs, to help curtail the problems of your lungs closing on you. You always want to have your inhaler handy. And not only asthmatics, but everybody can benefit from learning how to breathe properly. Number of ways to do it. Look, yeah, you know, I can put you on a steady state cardiovascular exercise like a elliptical or a jog at a certain pace and allow you to practice your breathing, and you can work on it and it can be good. But the problem is when boxing, you know, it's dynamic and things happen when you don't expect it. If I put you on the treadmill at 8 miles an hour, 20 minutes later, it's still going to be 8 miles an hour. If I put you in the ring, who knows what's going to happen 20 minutes later. So your goal as a fighter is to stay calm. Stay calm and learn how to breathe. Stay calm in tough situations, learn how to breathe. That's something that's going to come via experience. That's going to come something via just notching off rounds in the ring.
There you have it, Coach Brandon Krause, FeasterReport.com, and Melissa Beck reporting.